Little Fox.
Superstars in history. Steve Jobs. Welcome to my new smash hit, Superstars in History. I'm your host, Faye Moss, the only talk show host in the world with access to history's biggest stars. Each week, I interview people from the past who've changed history in unique ways. They love sharing their personal stories with me. Oh, and with you, too! You're going to be absolutely fascinated by my conversation with today's guest. He started a famous company, dramatically left it, and made a huge comeback later on. He's a computer pioneer who changed the world again and again. Straight from history, here's the founder of Apple, Steve Jobs!
Hello, Faye.
Hi, Steve. Thank you for being my guest on Superstars in History. Kids today will never know a world without smartphones or tablets. I certainly don't know what I'd do without all my smartphones and tablets. But you didn't have these devices when you were a kid. Tell me, what was your childhood like?
Well, I had a pretty normal childhood. I was born in 1955 and grew up in California, in a place that would become known as Silicon Valley. I hung out a lot with my dad, who loved working with his hands, building things, and fixing cars. He wasn't great with electronics, but he knew the basics from working on cars and taught me.
Did your dad teach you any secrets that helped you succeed?
I don't know if they were secrets, Faye, but my dad thought craftsmanship was really important. Whenever he built something, like a fence or a cabinet, he paid close attention to parts that wouldn't even be seen, like their backs. Later at Apple, I paid close attention to the design of each product too, making sure that everything looked sleek and was truly well made.
I've heard that you had a wide range of interests in school: literature, philosophy, and music. How did you become interested in technology?
Even in the 1960s, Silicon Valley was a big technology center. The Hewlett-Packard Company was already there making electronic devices. Plus, I went to school with kids whose parents were engineers, and my friends were really into electronics. Do you know Steve Wozniak, who...
Of course, I know Woz. He was your co-founder at Apple, right?
Yes, but that came later. Woz was already a genius when it came to electronics, and the two of us liked playing pranks. Once, Woz made a device that interrupted TV signals, which used to frustrate people so much. Eventually, we figured out how to make a blue box, too. This tricked phone lines into making expensive, long-distance calls for free. Illegally.
Those devices sound pretty complicated. How old were you at the time?
I was in my senior year of high school. After high school, I tried going to college, but dropped out after a semester. I didn't like taking the required courses. Eventually, I moved back home and got a job at a video game company. I also joined a club with Woz for computer hobbyists. By now, Woz had designed his own computer, and I realized it could sell really well. This machine became the Apple I, and in 1976, we founded the Apple Computer Company in my parents' garage. We made 200 Apple I computers and sold most of them within 10 months.
What was special about the Apple I? I mean, it doesn't look anything like a computer. Where's the monitor?
Actually, no computers at the time had monitors, as you know them today. With our Apple I, we just sold the computer, and people could use their own TVs for monitors. Soon, Woz started working on the Apple II. The Apple II was one of the first home computers, and when we started selling it, our company took off. In the early 80s, I developed the Macintosh, a great new computer that showed pictures on screen and used a mouse. This technology was all pretty new at the time.
I bet it was a huge success!
It wasn't a failure, but it wasn't the success we had hoped for. By then, other computers were available, and Apple lost its share of the market to competitors. The board of directors had grown unhappy with my performance as well. I left Apple and started another company called Next.
Wow! How did it feel to leave Apple, a company that you founded? You must have felt angry and betrayed.
I was upset, but later realized that I benefited from the change. I was young when Apple started, and I became rich and famous quickly. Too quickly. At Next, I was able to start over, learn new lessons, and make new mistakes. Meanwhile, the Next computers were too expensive, but the technology was exciting, and we were developing software that Apple wanted. So Apple bought Next, and soon I was back at Apple.
Apple wasn't very profitable when you returned in 1997. In fact, many people were expecting it to shut down. But it grew into one of the most successful companies in the world. How did you ever turn things around?
When I went back to Apple, the company was working on a lot of different projects. There wasn't much focus or vision. I decided we should work on a few core projects that we could do well. In 1997, only 37% of households in the US had a computer. There was also a new technology called the Internet. How could we make both computers and the Internet easier for people to use? In 1998, we released our answer to that question, the iMac. It was an all-in-one computer, ready to use almost right out of the box. And it had a friendly design that made technology less scary for many people. Within 5 months, we sold 800,000 of them, and 32% of those buyers were purchasing a computer for the first time.
Obviously, your early work at Apple was ahead of its time.
But by the 2000s, you were in the right place at the right time, producing innovative new products.
And now, people like me can't imagine life without them. Thank you for being here, Steve. We'll let you get back to history now.
Goodbye.
And thank you, everyone, for watching my exclusive interview with Steve Jobs. As you might know, the last major product he launched at Apple was the iPad in 2010. He had cancer at the time, but he kept on working. Finally, he became too ill to work and resigned from his day-to-day duties in 2011. Sadly, Steve Jobs died on October 5th of that year. He was only 56 years old. But he certainly made a huge impact on technology, as well as our everyday lives. That's all for today, but I'll be back soon with another exciting interview. You've been watching Famos, the talk show host with exclusive access to history's biggest stars.
Little Fox.